Alright, hey guys, it's Chez from the Gripsport. I want to make a quick video explaining how I train grippers. I actually used to have this video up a while back, but my YouTube account got hacked and all my videos got deleted, so I had to start over again. So a few people have been asking me. I'm making a return from injury. I tore my bicep, you know, a little over a year ago, but I'm actually getting back up to full strength. It was a long road. So when I train grippers, I actually train predominantly MMS, Mash Monster set. I'm gonna post a link in the description of how to do a Mash Monster set. It's actually Paul Knight's video. There's no point in me explaining it again because Paul did the best job he could possibly do. That's how I learned how to set a gripper. And it's, you know, there's no point in watching another video. He really breaks it down. And if you watch the video over and over again in practice, you'll get better. So the reason why I do Mash Monster set is because it gets you into that, you know, the power range of the gripper, that last 3/4 of an inch to an inch where the gripper really ramps up and you feel the full strength of the gripper. So when I get into the gym and I train grippers, I start off by doing some regular weightlifting movements to wake up my body. You know, the reason I do this is kind of like walking up to a bench press. You wouldn't just put, you know, whatever your max is and just do that. You would gradually warm up. So I warm up with full body movements and I warm up with grippers at the same time. The full body movements, I try to do some kind of compound movement. Squats are usually the best for people. So if you're doing squats, you know, this isn't gonna be like a crazy, crazy heavy session. It should be moderate intensity, somewhere in the 8 to 12 rep range. You know, you wanna get a good sweat. It's kind of like a boxer going into a fight. You know, you don't wanna go in cold. You wanna, you know, you want to be dead tired where you can't move, but you don't want to be cold. You want to have a good sweat going. So you can do that first, and then you can do, you know, your gripper session and warm up as well. You can do them interchangeably. So you can do a warm-up session with squats and then warm up with your grippers. So right now I'm not doing squats because I do my normal weightlifting during the week. So I've been doing hamstring curls and close grip bench press, what I did this past weekend. So I did that first and then I moved on to grippers. So now for grippers, I start pretty light. I start really light actually. The first gripper I use every session is a Captains of Crush Sport, and I do it for like 10 reps. And then I move on to a Captains of Crush 0.5 for 5 reps, a Captains of Crush number 1 for 3 reps. Then I go to a Captains of Crush number 2 for 1 rep, a 2.5 for 1 rep. I'll jump to a Captain's of Crush number 3 for 1 rep. And then this past weekend I went to a Tedding Elite, which is between a 3 and a 3.5 if you don't know. And I did that for 1 rep. And then I did a lighter number 3, which if you know anything about, you know, RGC and gripsport, the rating system we use in gripsport, this number 3.5 is 172 pounds. So I did that for 1 rep. And then I did my harder 3.5, which is 180 pounds RGC for 1 rep. So those were all counted as working, as warm-up sets. Now, obviously, the more advanced you are, you know, you're gonna have bigger jumps between your warm-ups. You know, if you guys have ever watched a really strong bench presser on YouTube, he takes entire plate jumps. He goes from like 135 to 225 to 315 to 405. But if you have a lower starting point, you're not going to take as big a jumps, and you're obviously going to use lighter grippers. You have to play around with the working sets, with the warm-up sets, and see what works best for you. So this past weekend, my working sets started with my 190-pound MM5 replica, because that's where I am right now with my training. I've been stronger in the past, but again, I'm coming back from surgery, so I'm still not quite at full strength. So what I do at this point with the working sets is I pick a gripper. I don't know. I had to do the percentages, but I would say it's, you know, maybe like 90 to 95%, probably closer to 95% of where my max is. And I do singles. So I do 4 heavy singles and I give myself time in between, you know, to relax in between each one. If you feel like you're cooling down a little bit, you can go back to doing some kind of weight training, like a set of squats, a set of push-ups, you know, tricep extensions, overhead press, whatever works for you. You gotta play around with that, whatever you get the best response from. So I'll hit it for a single, you know, I'll hit it for another single if I can. And then I'll keep going. If I can get all four singles with the gripper that I picked for the day, then I get all four singles with the gripper that I picked for the day. And it just so happened this past weekend, I got all four singles with my MM5. But let's say that didn't happen. Let's say I got, you know, the first one, and then I got the second one, but it was really, really hard. And the third one, I failed. So at that point, I would drop down. I would drop down to the next gripper in my collection. And for me, that would probably be my 186-pound MM3. And I would try to get that for the next single. And hopefully I would get it. If I didn't get it, I'd have to drop down again. At this point, I'd probably be working with my 182-pound RB330, I believe. It's RB330. And try to get that. So you see, like, you start with your highest gripper when you get to your work. So you pyramid up in the warm-up sets, right? And you have to think of a rep scheme that works for you. And you make the jump to your working sets. And you use the heaviest gripper that you're going to use for the day. And this is dependent on your last workout and where you think you're going to be. Obviously, if you test it out and it doesn't happen, you're going to have to adjust. So, and then you keep trying to go with it until you can't. You can get all four. That's great. Do it. If you can't, you can drop down. It's kind of like a modified drop set. You drop down as you get weaker and fatigue settles in. So this past weekend, I got all four with that. And then what I do is I move on to my doubles. Now, after four really intense, hard singles, you're gonna lose a little bit of power. You know, it happens. I don't know how good, you know, your endurance is, but for me, after four, you know, that's, I can't keep hitting those heavy ones forever, so I gotta drop down. So this past weekend, I busted out my 176-pound MM3 for the doubles. And I stuck with that, and I did three doubles. And I got all three doubles with the 176-pound MM3. Now, to show you an idea of how you progress from workout to workout, last workout, because I keep a training log, I used, for my doubles, I started with 176-pound MM3, but then I dropped down to my 174-pound RB280 for the other two doubles. So, you know, but it felt good, so this week I made a note to myself, try doing all three doubles with 176-pound MM3. So that's how I progress. So, and then after those, you know, doubles in the same fashion. You drop down if you have to. You keep the same if you have to. Then I go to triples. So again, to show you the progression, I think two sessions ago, I used my 165-pound Tedding Elite for the triples, and I got all three of them, and I made a note to myself that it was easy. It actually was pretty easy, so I knew I had to move up to another gripper. So this past session, I did my 167-pound Captain's of Crush number 3.5, and I got them no problem. I actually got them no problem the workout before too, but I decided to keep them the same because I was moving up for my singles and my doubles, so I kept those the same. So that's the basis of my program. It's the warming up, you know, using full body movements to warm yourself up, warming up with grippers too at the same time until you get to your working singles. And then as fatigue sets in, you're gonna have to drop down grippers to keep the singles going. And when I say four singles, I mean those are four made singles. So if I miss one in between and I have to drop down a gripper, I don't count the miss. Same thing with the doubles and the triples. And then you'd have to, you know, pick your double gripper and your triple gripper. Now you got to keep detailed notes of how hard it was and stuff like that, because that's what's going to let you know what to pick for next workout. And you know, we all have good days and bad days. You know, when you actually go to do it, you know, you may have a bad day and you have to just adjust on the fly and pick a different gripper. So that's the main basis of my program. That's what I explained in my first video, but over time I've added tweaks and found different things. So if anybody remembers my first video, I said that I don't do a lot of, you know, unusual techniques, you know, like strap holds or filed grippers, or I specifically said negatives. But I eventually got up to closing a couple of Captains of Crush number fours, and I had to dig into the bag of tricks to get to that level. So when I got to a sticking point, I did start incorporating negatives. But this is how I do negatives. If you've only been doing grippers for like a year, I wouldn't even do the negatives. Just do that main program that I talked about, the doubles, triples, and singles. If you feel like it's not enough work volume for you, you can throw a few more in. But start with that. And then this is pretty intense because you're going pretty heavy. So for me, the next thing in my current program is that I would do negatives. The reason why I do negatives second is for two, it's negatives are very dangerous. Anybody who's ever been hurt training crush usually gets hurt with negatives because you're using such a heavy weight, you're forcing it closed and you're holding it. There's been a couple guys who have torn things in their hands. One that comes to mind really quickly is Gabriel Sum in Germany, who is certified in the Captain's Crush 3.5. You know, he's done some amazing things on YouTube with grippers, and he was doing a negative and he tore something in his hand. So the reason why I do them second is that way I'm pre-fatigued, I'm already tired, so I can use less resistance. You see the common trend here is I go down as I get tired, but they're still hard because I'm tired. So for negatives, I've used a couple things in the past. I used the Pops Sorenex Crush Booster from the Grip Machine. It's kind of like a secret weapon. It has that attachment on the guillotine gripper. I used that. I actually sold that because I moved into a smaller place and I didn't have the room. Right now I use an extended handle Robert Barabon adjustable gripper. So it has the extended handle for negatives. And what I do is I actually learned this from Morgan on the grip board, is that I hold the adjustable gripper downward on the floor and with the extended handle on the floor. And then with the regular handle up in the air, I put my weight on it. I press it down with my weight to get it closed. And you can even pick up from the top of the U spring where the extension spring is wrapped. So you can help with this, and it really helps you cheat close some really heavy settings. And then I pick it up in the air. And what I do is I hold it for, it used to be a 10 second count. I did that for a while. Now I'm down to a 5 second count. That's another thing that I do to make it safer. I don't use a resistance that will rip my hand open right away. It used to be 10 seconds, but now because I'm trying to push up the intensity a little bit, I'm going to 5 seconds. I suggest you start with 10 seconds and start lighter with these if you do them. But full disclosure, these are dangerous. So start light. Don't do them unless you have a good amount of time training so your tendons are strong and used to abuse. So I do, right now in my current routine, I do 5 heavy negatives with 5 second holds after that pyramid routine that I told you about. And so now I told you I train predominantly MMS, but when I'm getting ready for something like a certification, say Captains of Crush certification where they use the credit card, or a competition where they use a block set, I do throw in that kind of work. So right now, the competition is a little bit less than 4 months away that I'm getting ready for, and they're using a 30 millimeter block, which is, I think, is like 1.2 inches. I don't know, I forgot, I did the conversion. It's close to 1.2 inches. So after the negatives, then I go to some 30 millimeter block work. So I will pick a gripper, same concept. I will pick the heaviest gripper that I think I can close with a 30 millimeter block at this point in my workout. So this past weekend, you gotta remember, after doing 190-pound gripper 4 times, 176-pound RGC gripper 3 times, 167-pound RGC gripper for 3 sets of triples, those were 3 doubles before with the 176, and then doing heavy negatives, I'm getting a little tired. So this week I moved up and I used my 172-pound COC number 3.5. The session before, I used my 165, and it just felt too easy, so I made a note to myself that I have to move up, and that's what I was using my block work with. So a block set is when you take the block, you put it between the handles as a starting point, and you close it. This is 30 millimeters, which I think is about 1.2 inches. So I got 5 singles with that. And again, same concept. If I can only get 2 singles with it, I would drop down to my next gripper down, which would probably be my 167 COC 3.5. And then it would be my 165 elite, and I'd finish out the singles. So that's another thing too. Like nowadays, we're pretty blessed that we have so many different high quality grippers. You got the Captains of Crush, the GHP, Teddings. Even though he doesn't make them anymore, you can still get them on Weightlifters Warehouse. You can find them used on Canon Power Works, even though he's not actively making them. So like I told you about the rating system that we have in gripsport, where we put the gripper on the side, and we put a 1-inch strap on the handle, and we put weight on the strap until it closes the handle. Since it's all the way at the end of the handle, it's usually lower than the manufacturer's rating, because the manufacturer's rating is in the middle of the handle. So that weight is the ratings that I've been mentioning. I found that the fastest way to improve a grippers is to have a lot of incremental jumps. So early on in my gripper training, I was always looking for a 5 pound jump. So I have a gripper collection where from a number 3 up to past the number 4, I have pretty consistent 5 pound jumps. I have a 149 COC number 3, a 153 COC number 3, a 160 MM1, a 165 Elite, a 171 Elite, a 172 3.5, you know, and so on and so on, 5 pound jumps. I think 5 pound jumps are pretty manageable. Usually when I can, for those singles, you know, those singles in the beginning of my workout, when I can close the same gripper 3 to 4 times in a row for those singles, I'm ready for the next jump, which is usually around 5 pounds. It just works out that way. If I can dominate the gripper for 3 to 4 singles, I make a note to myself, it's time to try the next higher gripper in my collection. And it's worked pretty good. It worked this past weekend. It's worked a lot in the past. So this upcoming session, I'm going to be trying my 194-pound Super Elite. And I feel pretty confident I can get at least one close off of it, if not more. That's the main routine. You know, you get it. So you start with the regular, you know, singles, doubles, and triples, and the pyramiding cascade down, you know, adjusting as you get tired. Then I do the negatives, and then I do the whatever type of specialized work you want to do, if it's credit card sets or block sets. Now, right now my goal is the Mash Monster level 7 gripper. I want to get that certification. I'm number 6 right now. That was at my peak strength, and then I got distracted by life, and then I got injured. So I'm trying to make a return to that. That's why I'm focusing so much on Mash Monster set. This routine can probably be adjusted for something else. Like if you want to do block sets, you could do that singles, doubles, and triples with block sets. You could probably do it with credit card sets. I still think the Mash Monster set should be the basis. It should be those singles, doubles, and triples most of the time. And then you throw in the specialized work as you get stronger and get closer to your whatever you're going for, a certification or a comp that requires something different. I'm a firm believer that a high Mash Monster set close trickles down to other types of sets. If you are closing a 200-pound gripper with a Mash Monster set, you can probably credit card set a 3.5 pretty easily without too much training with it. And you can probably block set something in between that too. So you see, it kind of trickles down. But obviously, as you get closer to your certification competition, you want to get used to that set, so you start throwing it in more. So maybe like about 2 months out from the competition, I will change the order of the block set work and the negative. So my block set work will come after, directly after my MMS work. So I'm fresher, so I can hit it fresher, and then my negatives, and I'll have to adjust the numbers there. I'm gonna have to go up in the block sets and go down the negatives, obviously because of the fatigue factor. And then when it gets within the last month of the competition, I'm probably even a little closer. Yeah, I think the last month I might throw in just the block sets from the beginning with the same routine. So you see, you can adjust, you can adapt and mold this program. Another thing I want to talk about is training frequency. When you are newer to grippers and you're using less, you know, difficult grippers and your training sessions aren't that severe, I found I could train more often in the beginning. I did 2 times a week. As time went on, I don't know, I can't give you a time frame. I had to look back at my log. As time went on, I had to switch to once a week. And then eventually I had to switch to once every 1.5 weeks. And right now, currently, I'm doing once every 2 weeks. So I'm going to talk about my training split right now and talk about how it's changed. And right now my training split is that I train regular weightlifting during the week. 2 days a week, I do the 5-3-1 powerlifting program. It's a good program. It's pretty simple. It's pretty basic. And I have a 2-day split which really works on my schedule. One day is bench and squat with some accessories. The next day is deadlifts and overhead press with some accessories. So it's usually either Tuesday or Thursday or Wednesday and Friday, depending on my schedule for the week. And then on Saturday and Sunday is when I train grip. So here's how it goes. So weightlifting is really important for grip. If you want to set big grippers, you're going to need a big upper body. You're going to need big shoulders. You're going to need big arms. To set a gripper, it takes a lot of upper body power. And also, it will just make your grip stronger in general. You know, have you ever seen strong men who try a grip exercise for the first time and they dominate because of just how big and powerful they are? It is true that if you want to maximize your grip strength, not just in grippers, but other grip implements, you should do some form of weight training. And then another important thing to know, where was I going with this? It's a little time. I was pretty late and I'm pretty tired. The split. Okay, so my current split, it rotates. I just don't have the time to fit everything in a week. I used to do I break grip up into crush, which is grippers, pinch, which is, you know, regular pinch, which is like around 2 inches, wide pinch, and then thin pinch, whatever you want to do. And then I do thick bar, which is like fat revolving handles, axle, stuff like that. And then wrist work, which is levering with sledgehammers and stuff like that. I'll probably make a video about those exercises, separate videos for those, because this video is already running long. But so let's take day one, which will be a Saturday. This past weekend, I'll use as a great example. This past weekend, I did grippers and thick bar on Saturday. So grippers and thick bar are the two things in your training cycle which are really hard to balance. Usually when you go up on one, you go down on the other. Right now for this competition that I'm training for, you only need to use one hand for each event. So for grippers, I'm going to use my right hand because this is my dominant crush hand. For thick bar, I'm going to use my left hand. For some reason, I'm just stronger left hand on thick bar. I don't know why. That's just the way it is. Some people are better one hand than other on certain events, and you'll have to find what you're better on. So because of that, this past Saturday, I trained grippers first with my right hand because I wanted to train them before I did thick bar because I didn't want to fry my hand up. My main goal is crush right now. I have some things that I want to accomplish. I still want to get good for the comp. But because I'm not going to use the right hand in the competition for thick bar, it doesn't matter if I do thick bar after I've fried my hand a little bit from grippers. Because, you know, I'm not going to be using it in the comp. I'm still training it. So I'll do my gripper routine. I did my gripper routine with my right hand. And then I did my thick bar routine with my left and right hand. So obviously my left hand's using more weight because it's naturally stronger. My right hand is already fatigued from grippers and it's weaker. So I had to use less weight with that. But that's okay because this thing, you know, I'm not going to be using this that much, you know, in the comp. And then, so that's my Saturday with the regular weight training. On Sunday, I do some more, like, you know, assistance exercises, just things I couldn't get to during the week. You know, Saturday, some assistance exercises I couldn't get to during the week. But Sunday, I do those assistance exercises, and I do my wrist training. And, you know, that's levering, you know, sledge deadlifts from the floor, levering to the front like this, levering to the back like that, supination, pronation, wrist curls, reverse wrist curls. That's what I do to get the wrist strong. A lot of guys overlook wrist strength. Wrist strength is really, really important. Actually, my wrists were naturally very, very weak when I first started training grip. They were my worst area, and I had to work hard to bring them up. They're still not that good. They're still a weakness. But whenever my wrists are strong, everything else is stronger, especially grippers, because it's the base of your hand. It gives you like that rock solidness. You can steady the gripper. You're not shaking like crazy. You get that solid base to push off when you're setting your gripper. Wrist strength is really important. So that's the first weekend. So then I go through my regular weightlifting during the week, and I come back the next weekend. So on Saturday for the next weekend, I'm doing my left hand with grippers, right? But here's the change. I'm also doing pinch, right? A lot of people only know this, but pinch actually is great to do before grippers. Either you do it the workout right before, a day or two before, or like I do, because I only have the weekend, I do it right before in the same workout. So I'll do my pinch training. Now right now my pinch training is working on the flask, which is 58 millimeters, so it's kind of like a normal pinch. So I do that first, my pinch routine, and then I do my left-hand grippers. It doesn't hurt my left-hand grippers. In fact, it actually helps my left-hand grippers. I do better when I do pinch first. I don't know what it is, it's kind of like a primer. And working pinch is kind of important because it builds up this thumb pad so that you have a nice big wall to push against when you're setting a gripper. So I do my pinch work first, and then I do my left-hand grippers. And you know, left-hand grippers are also very important for me because I'm trying to certify in a Mash Monster Level 3 gripper this year with my left hand, my offhand, and only one other man has done that, and that's Paul Knight. I am probably about 5 pounds RGC away from that, so I'm getting close. So then I do that gripper routine I talked about with my left hand. And then that Sunday, same session with accessories and wrist work. I do wrist work every weekend. Just because it's a weakness of mine and so important. So that's one that I do every weekend while the other workouts I do. So that's what I'm currently doing. When I had more time, I was doing all the workouts. you know, pinch, crush, wrist, and thick bar in whatever kind of split I was in. So if I was doing it over the course of a week, I did it over the course of a week, over a course of 1.5 weeks, or a course of 2 weeks, and spread it out during the week. Now, if you do it that way, you really got to think about the arrangement, right? So this is the arrangement I used to use when I was doing it over the course of a week or 1.5 weeks. Grippers and thick bar have to be as far apart as possible because they just don't go hand in hand. You're going to fry yourself out from one, it's going to hurt the other one. So like say day one is your pinch routine. I would follow I take like a day or two rest, probably 2 days, and then do my crush routine. You could do both hands on the same day. I split them up because I found that I was focusing. I would get tired by the time I got to my off hand, and it wouldn't get as much work. So if I did my dominant hand first, which let's face it, we're all going to do our dominant hand first because that's our money maker. It's what we're going for the certs with. Until I got to my left hand, I was just physically tired. So that's why I split them up. But I used to do them both on the same day. It doesn't matter. You figure it out in the schedule, but these are the, you know, guidelines. So pinch would be day one. Take day two. At least day two off, maybe day three, but sometimes you could just do day three. You could do the crush training. So you do your crush training. Like I said, pinch is a great primer for crush, so I always put it before crush. And then I would do wrist work, again, taking a day off or 2 days off after grippers, do my wrist work, and then take another day off or 2 days off and do my thick bar work. So you see the cycle? You start with pinch, day or two, crush, a day or two, wrist. You're trying to split the grippers and the wrist work as far as possible. Then I would do crush a day or two later. So then when you repeat the cycle, you're back at pinch, so you're not a crusher. So that's as far as part as you can get. You know, you got these two, you got these two. So you're keeping grippers and thick bar apart. Pinch and crush, you know, they don't really affect each other as much. So you can just kind of use them as the buffers, the other ones. That's one way I did it. I did it for a long time and it was successful. And that's how I closed Captain's Crush number fours. I'm actually having great success right now with my current split that I explained earlier. Like I had a choice, really. It's the best thing I could come up with my current schedule. I only have 2 days for grip and 2 days for weightlifting. That's the best I could come up with. But I'm soaring. I'm going up in all things. So that pretty much, I think that does a good job explaining. The video is getting close to 30 minutes. So, you know, send me any questions you have. I hope this helped. This is just how I train. It's not the only way to train. Again, I focus on low reps because those build power. I'm trying to close big grippers. The crazy high reps never worked for me. They just got me better at doing high reps. That's why I do the singles, doubles, and triples, and the negatives, and you know, stuff like that, because that's how you get to the really high numbers. That's what works for most people. So give this a shot, and if you do, you know, let me know how it goes. I'm really curious. I haven't seen anybody stick with my routine for a while. Some people did it for a while and they got really good results, but I think they got distracted in training. So if you do this and you do it for a while, let me know. And the key to this program is always to think about the next step. Always try to improve from last time. So if you got 3 singles with a certain gripper, try to get 4 singles with it. If you got 4 singles with it, try to move up to the next gripper and get at least 1 single with it, and you can get other singles with the last gripper. And the same thing for doubles and triples. Always try to improve somehow. And, you know, even if it's like getting an extra set of triples, or maybe you get 4 instead of 3 to help you bridge the gap to your next gripper. You get the progression, right? You're always trying to add a little bit more weight and a little bit more progression. And you're also trying to get stronger too. That's why I do 5-3-1, because it has the same type of progression. You're always using more and more weight. So you want to get stronger here, you want to get stronger in grippers. So I hope that explains it. Let me know if it does, and hope it works for you. Sorry it took me so long to make this video. All right, thanks guys, bye.